whose whole life has been continually put to the test by circumstances unforeseen. Fondly called by our MI kids as Daddy Wawel, Mr. Emmanuel Mercado has managed to turn all the unfortunate circumstances beset before him into great opportunities of resiliency and parenting. Minutes after giving birth to their firstborn, the Mercado family experienced a family tragedy when Mila suffered an amniotic fluid embolism. As a result, she has become permanently paralyzed from the head down. Despite this and many other related incidents, Wawel found solace in his faith and a deeper strength to push back and rise above his situation. Using his personal experiences as a springboard, Wawel has advocated for the proper implementation of the accessibility law to help persons with disabilities. He has also spoken in behalf of many others who share his plight through articles both online and published. Joining and completing the 27th National Milo Marathon, Wawel and Mila spoke through the greatest of actions about the importance of proper health care for everyone. But I think more than anything, Wawel has taught the MI community the true meaning of unconditional love. Our intrapersonal award goes to Mr. Emmanuel Mercado for using his self-smart to inspire others.
Accept this really for Mila, and I think we are here largely because of a promise. When Mila was 2 weeks in her coma, she was given a 2% chance of ever waking up. Her doctor told us that she will be most likely persistently vegetative. At that time, my prayer was, Lord, give us the 2%, wake Mila up. And my promise was that if Mila wakes up, I will tell her story. I will speak about God's miracle. When Mila woke up, she lost her ability to speak. Her profound brain injuries paralyzed her. Yet, through God's grace, Mila is able to share her story. Though Mila cannot speak, her story has been told in churches, in schools, in recollections, and in homilies. And though Mila cannot speak, her story has been told in newspapers, in magazines, in radio, and in television. And what is Mila's story? I think Mila's story is very simple. Mila's story is that God is faithful to all loving families. Mila's story is that God is faithful to the weakest among us, to people with disabilities, to children with special needs. Mila's story is that God loves the least among us, people who are powerless, people who have no voice. So I thank the MI community for helping us tell Mila's story. And I accept this award, really, on behalf of my wife, Mila, whom I love very dearly. Thank you very much. Our last awardee.